All right, so the once every four-year soccer feast is already underway.
World Cup's up for grabs in Africa for the very first time. And the host nation, South Africa, faced Mexico this morning in the Johannesburg opener. News 5's Andrew Setters hit the bars to see who was watching.
This morning, while you were maybe thinking about having your second cup of coffee, there were plenty of soccer fans who were already on their second pint of beer. World Cup fever kicking off a month-long celebration in the tri-state, too. They're just as loud as a Bengals crowd, but there's a different kind of football on the screen. Molly Malone's in Covington opened up early this morning for day one of World Cup soccer.
Not everybody works 9 to 5, you know what I mean? So a lot of people have taken vacation, a lot of people have taken days off, you know?
People were having a few drinks and some food, watching host country South Africa take on Mexico starting at 9:30 this morning. And with 64 games spread out over the next month, this crowd will get tight.
I don't know many of the guys here, but by the end of the tournament, we'll definitely be best friends with everybody.
And starting tomorrow, there'll be a lot of people cheering for Team USA.
Hope the U.S. gets out of their group, maybe advance a couple rounds and just beat England. If they beat England, I'm happy.
One sure winner will be bars that open up early and draw in the soccer crowd, their cash, and their excitement during what would normally be a quiet time of the day.
I talked to a couple guys that said they'd be asleep right now if it wasn't for World Cup soccer.
I might be asleep myself if it wasn't for World Cup soccer. I didn't get much sleep last night, but that way, but it's all good, though. I mean, it's awesome. It's fun.
So if you're a hardcore soccer fan or maybe a soccer novice, you have plenty of opportunities to watch soccer during the World Cup with a lot of fans in the tri-state who know the game very well. For Molly Malone's in Covington, Andrew Setters, News 5.